That's right.
You killed him. He was going to help me, and you killed him.
I had to, Sally. He was going to take you away. Now, come on.
No! Get away from me! No. Catelyn!
Catelyn can't save you now. Come on! It's time for us to take that little trip. A trip I've been looking forward to for such a very long time.
You sure about this?
No, I'm not sure. This is what the note says.
Why don't you have him be here?
Do I have ESP? Let's go. Everything's gonna be fine now.
Another World. This part is brought to you by Lemon Fresh Joy. Joy cleans down to the shine for a sparkle everyone can see. For beautiful dishes, let your joy show.
This is Davenport's counter proposal. Personally, I don't like it much.
Right, I'll look at it later.
Actually, I think his figures are a little unrealistic. Now, I've made notes in the margins where he's really way off.
Fine, I'll let you know after I've studied it.
Huh.
Sandy?
Yeah?
I had a visit from your father earlier today.
Oh, really?
You told him about the sculpture, didn't you?
Sally!
Sally.
Sally, where is she? Where is she?
Ross.
Ross, where did he take her? Where did he take Sally?
Mountain House. Mountain House.
He's dead. The Mountain House. Where the devil is the Mountain House?
Sally, where's the mountaintop house? I see a friend over there. He's dead. You want to end up like him?
No, I got you.
Where?
The road to the mountain.
Where?
First turn after the church.
You're not going anywhere.
Peter is here? I don't believe it.
Somehow, I do.
Where is he now? Well, he went with Catelyn and the priest to go get Sally.
How did he know enough to come to Majorca?
Well, it's kind of a long story, but basically he put together a lot of information and somehow figured out that you all were here.
A regular Sherlock Holmes.
What I don't understand is how Peter found Catelyn. I mean, I know this is a small island, but...
Well, he's not hard to miss.
Well, I'm not sure if I've got it totally straight, but I think what happened is that Catelyn somehow stumbled on the place where they were keeping Sally.
That must be Frank Wells Ranch.
Right. I think that was the name of it. I can't remember now because it all happened so fast. My head is just spinning.
So how come he brought you along?
Well...
You remember, don't you? Emily and Peter are constant companions.
Peter's had to have been so lonely these past few months.
So, Catelyn found a ranch, and then what?
Well, I think what happened next is that Catelyn somehow called the police station, and Peter just happened to be there.
What an amazing coincidence.
What's terrific is that Sally's safe. She's okay.
Yeah, that's right. Why don't we all just, ride on over to the ranch and watch the roundup?
Oh, no, Peter gave strict instructions that nobody's supposed to leave till he gets back.
Well, what are we supposed to do? Sit here and twiddle our thumbs while he makes like the hero?
I know what you need.
Yeah, what's that?
A drink.
Oh, that sounds great.
Let's celebrate. Some sangria. Won't you join me?
Perfect. Sounds wonderful.
I'd love to.
I suppose.
Well, whoever would have thought that it would all end up this way?
Hmm? Yeah.
I wasn't quite sure it was going to end at all.
This certainly isn't what I had in mind.
Yes. Here we are.
Wonderful.
Thanks.
Oh, that's good.
Well, to your health.
Very strange thing happened, Sandy.
What's that?
Mac came over here, and he accused me of destroying Rachel's sculpture, her statue. And you told him, didn't you?
Why in the world would I tell my father about Rachel's sculpture? It would only cause trouble.
Well, that's... Well, I did wonder.
Carl, Blaine and I talked about Rachel's piece. Now, you know her attitude. I mean, I would hardly be the one to bring it up to my father.
Ah, Blaine again, is it?
Hmm? Yes. And why would you think that I had talked to Mac?
Well, you just seem very interested in the statue. I mean, you even offered to buy it.
Well, I like the sculpture. It was beautiful.
It is beautiful. No harm has come to it.
Of course not, Carl. The whole idea is ridiculous.
Indeed.
Just as ridiculous as you thinking that I was the one who talked to Mac. I thought you trusted me more than that.
Why? I still can't believe that little perky Emily Benson is a cold-blooded murderer.
Just goes to show.
What?
Looks deceived.
I've always said so. Red. Three lousy little spaces.
This ain't exactly a game of skill, is it?
You know, you'd think Mr. Pollock would at least have a deck of cards around here. Nothing but little Maggie's games.
Hey, it says here they think she may have poisoned Peter.
Nonsense. She isn't even 3 years old yet.
Talk about Emily, you idiot.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was preoccupied. You could still be sent back, you know. You draw the ice cream card and you're dead.
They're saying that Emily poisoned Peter?
Yeah. Police theorize. At least that's the phrase they use here.
Yeah, but weren't the two of them in a...
Two of them what?
Sleeping together?
Yeah.
Wally. Well, I would assume so. At least I hope so.
So?
Well, I may be old-fashioned, but I can't quite feature poisoning the man you're going to bed with.
Women's lib.
Oh, but Wally, but even so.
Yeah, even so. You know, if you follow this in the chronological order, you have to remember that Peter was poisoned the day he was supposed to marry Cecile.
So that's why he left her at the altar. I never knew that.
That's why. And you have to assume that he and Emily weren't sleeping together right way back then.
Well, I should hope not.
Cecile would have poisoned her.
You're not kidding. So wait a minute. Now, if you assume that Emily did in fact poison Peter, and this is before they were an item, so to speak, and so after they got intimate, they must have had some terrible burning secret between them. Oh, that's wonderful, isn't it?
Sounds a little kinky to me.
No, it's wonderful, at least for a plot for a romance novel, right, Wally?
Oh, I like it, Felicia. I wonder if your lawyer friend Peter would.
Yeah, I wonder. Hey, wait a minute. Listen to this. Miss Benson has not been seen or heard from since she arranged a leave of absence at Bay City General Hospital last week.
So?
What'd they think? She was gonna send them a postcard?
No, I mean, if you're a murderer, I mean, why would you go to the trouble of arranging a leave of absence? What, you need somebody to cover for you? Why wouldn't you just walk out the door?
Well, so she's a murderer. She's a very responsible murderer.
Oh, come on.
Well, you have to admire that, Felicia.
Don't be ridiculous.
No. Maybe she was just stalling for time. I mean, she cut out right before Mark Singleton named her, right?
Yeah, that's true. Whoa, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I just realized something. Do you know, the day that we finally found that flight bag with all the letters in it, Emily was with us.
She was?
Yeah.
How come?
Well, I mean, she was always with Peter.
Poor Pete.
So that means that she knew what we were doing every step of the way. I mean, she even helped with the investigation.
Oh, boy.
So she knew exactly what we were getting at.
Felicia, do you think she knew that Cass went to Mallorca?
No. Well, I don't think she did. Well, we didn't even tell Peter.
You didn't? Why not?
Cass told us not to.
Well, you told the police, didn't you?
Well, not exactly.
Why not, Felicia?
Cass told us not to.
Well, he was very definite.
Right, very.
Well, this may be none of my business at all, but I think you should get on the phone and call Peter or somebody and tell them where Cass is.
You really think I should do that?
Yes, you should, Felicia. If that sweet, perky little nurse took a trip to Mallorca, Cass Winthrop could be in big trouble.
Kathleen, would you like a little more sangria?
Oh, why not? You know, I normally don't like sangria, but this has a bitterness to it that kind of undercuts the sweetness of the fruit.
I'm glad you like it. Cecile?
Yes, I'd love some.
It's my own secret recipe.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
It's just delicious. Though, I think I should probably be having a cup of coffee instead.
Oh, no. Rest and enjoy it after what you've been through.
That's true. Tell me, Emily, whose house is this anyway?
Oh, I think it belongs to some relative of Peter's, somebody who only uses it once or twice a year.
Another love residence.
Oh, really? Peter never told me about this place.
Well, it's somebody on his mother's side. Cass, can I freshen up your drink?
No, thanks.
Oh, come on, this is a party.
I'm not in a party mood.
Cass.
What?
Come on.
Well, aren't you thrilled that this whole thing is finally almost over?
Yeah, sure. I'm just not thrilled that I did all the legwork and now Peter's come to claim the glory.
I'm sure there'll be plenty of glory to go around.
Well, you all deserve it. You must be exhausted.
Actually, I am pretty sleepy.
Well, you know, there's some bedrooms upstairs if you'd like to go lie down.
I'm feeling rather tired myself. Maybe I'll take you up on that, Emily.
Right upstairs and to the left.
Okay.
I don't think I have the energy.
Well, no rush.
Upstairs.
I'm just going to go put some ice in there.
Have you seen Carl?
He stepped out for a moment. He should be back soon.
Well, I hope he'll be back soon. We have a meeting at the hospital. I don't want to be late.
Oh, right. The executive committee.
Yes, will you be there?
No, I don't think so. I'm just on the board, Donna. The executive committee is a little too rarefied for me.
Well, I'm sure you'll be there soon.
Yeah, we'll see.
Sandy, what kind of a mood is Carl in today?
So? Why?
He seems to have been rather upset lately. Haven't you noticed?
Well, as a matter of fact, yes, I have.
He seems like he might be having some problem in the business. Is he?
No, nothing I can think of.
He's just very tense and changeable.
Donna, tell me something, would you?
Yes.
Did you know Carl's father?
No.
He died before Carl and I ever met. Why?
I don't know. It's just that Carl mentioned his father the other day, and, well, it seemed kind of strange. In fact, he seems a little touchy on the whole subject of fathers and sons. I just wondered if it might have something to do with his general attitude.
Carl's father committed suicide, Sandy.
I see.
So naturally, he would be rather touchy on the subject.
Yes. Do you know the reason why?
No, I don't. But if you really want to know, I think you should ask Carl.
Well, I think that's a subject I probably shouldn't bring up.
Oh, there you are. I was hoping you wouldn't forget.
Not just luck.
Now.
Just teasing, Bella. Of course, I'll be there.
Well, I think I'm finished up here. I'll get out of your hair.
Right. Let me hang on to this one. Will I see you later?
Yes, I think so. Goodbye, Donna.
Sandy.
Are you ready? We don't have much time.
Just a moment. What were you and Sandy discussing?
Well, if you must know, I was telling him that you seemed rather upset lately.
Really? Did Sandy concur?
He hadn't noticed. But you have been, haven't you?
Of course I've been upset, Bella. The woman in my life has been in prison. How could I fail but be upset?
Sometimes I feel that you rather I'd stayed there, that no one had ever found out the truth about Emily Benson.
What an extraordinary thing to say.
Well, what else could I conclude? You took your sweet time in trying to get a lawyer for me. You did everything you could to keep Brian from being my defense.
You put Peter in charge. I merely wanted to get you the best defense available, and it takes time to get the best lawyer.
Was that it?
Your time behind prison bars has made you a bit paranoid, Donna. Come on, let's go.
Alicia, why didn't you tell me about this before? Cass pulls a wild
thing. I'm sorry, Peter, really. I told you as soon as I learned all this about Emily.
But it's a little late.
Yeah.
But even if we'd known sooner, I mean, what could we have done?
You could have told me about it, that's what.
Yes, I know, we should have. I feel terrible about it. My only excuse is that Cass told me not to.
Do you think Miss Benson could have gone to Mallorca?
It's possible.
So what's our next move?
You don't move at all. I go to Larry and MJ and tell them what Felicia told me, and I find out how they want me to handle it.
Yeah.
Where are the letters?
Oh, they're right here in the flight bag. Listen, I told Cass that he shouldn't leave without talking to you first, Peter, but, well, he wouldn't listen.
Cass is a fool.
Yeah.
And if he isn't careful, he's going to wind up dead.
Lucille, are you sure you don't want to go upstairs and lie down?
No, I'm fine.
Boy, Kathleen is really out of it. I suppose you can't blame them.
No, I suppose not. You know, it's really amazing to me how quickly you and Peter got over here from the States.
Oh, yeah, we were really lucky. We just jumped right on a plane. Of course, Peter does have connections.
Yeah, right. I guess you didn't have time to pack, did you?
No, but Peter said we could buy everything we needed when we got here.
Yeah, sure. After all this is over, you'll be able to go on a real shopping spree, huh?
Oh, won't that be fun?
Yeah. They ought to be there at Wells Ranch by now, don't you think? Peter, Catelyn, and the police?
Could be.
I think I'll call over there and see what's happening.
Oh, no, don't do that.
Why not?
Well, because if you call before they get there, you could spoil the whole plan.
What plan?
Well, they're planning to surprise Mr. Wells. Otherwise, the whole thing could be blown.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Well, I know. I'll call the police and ask them what's going on.
You know, I wanted to do that, but unfortunately the phone is out of order.
Isn't that something? Just when you need it, huh?
Well, I'm not worried because Peter said that he'd come here with Catelyn just as soon as they rescue Sally.
Sally?
Sally's going to be just fine.
Oh, good.
I'm really tired. I'm really exhausted.
Yeah, I think it might be the sangria. Don't drink anymore, okay?
I'll have to go upstairs and lie down.
No, no, don't do that.
But I'm too tired, Cass. I have to go
upstairs.
Yeah,
but don't you want to be the first to greet our hero, Peter, when he arrives, huh?
Okay. That's true, I do. So I'll lie down here for a few minutes, all right?
Good.
Okay.
Oh, that's strong stuff.
You hardly touched yours.
What's the matter? Don't you like it?
No, it's swell.
I made it just for you.
Did you now? That's very sweet of you. Thanks. I have to say, I'm glad that this is all coming to a close.
Mm, aren't we all?
Yeah. Although, thinking back on everything that's happened, some of it was very funny. Real madcap stuff.
High adventure?
Yeah. Kind of zany, you know? For example, Cecile dressing up as a maid in order to try and sneak Sally out of her room. I mean, could you picture her as a maid? Really. Catlin must have told you and Peter about that, didn't he?
Oh, yes, he did. That was so funny.
Yeah. Ladies. Ladies! Come on, wake up.
What?
Oh, come don't.
On. Put your feet on the ground, rise and shine.
No, just a few minutes, okay? Just a
no, it's time to wake up. Come on, I'm sorry. No. The three of us are going to take a walk here. Come on,
let
Kathleen.
Them sleep. What could it hurt?
You tell me. Catlin didn't know that Cecile dressed up as a maid, so there was no way you could know either. Come on, Kathleen, Cecile, we've got to go. Come on.
Yeah.
Come on, up,
oh,
up,
no,
up.
Kathleen,
come on, Cecile.
Don't,
get up on your
I
feet,
don't
honey. Come
want
on.
To.
Come on, Kathleen.
I'm too
come
tired.
On, it's time to wake up.
I'm sorry, Cass. You're not going anywhere.
The next part of Another World.
Cecile, Kathleen, wake up.
I can't hear you.
What did you put in that sangria?
Something to make them sleep.
I guess it worked.
Drink up.
You think I'm crazy?
Consider the alternative.
A woman's hand. With a ring. That's what Sally saw.
Drink it, Cass.
You're the woman with the ring, not Donald Love, you.
Drink it or I'll use this.
You killed David Thatcher and Royal Dunning. Why?
I had to. David Thatcher could have exposed the whole operation. Everything I've done has been good. For the babies.
The babies that Dunning was selling?
People who buy babies want babies. Babies to love. And cherish the way babies should be.
And that's what Dunning was after?
Dr. Dunning got greedy. That's why he had to die. He could have ruined everything.
But he didn't.
My work will never stop. Never. Now drink up. I have to get out of here.
And what about Ross? Is he into babies too?
Ross is evil, but he's necessary. I never liked the killing. I don't want any more. But I have to save my babies. And if you try to stop me, I'll shoot you too.
Emily, please. I know you're only trying to help.
Drink it. All of it. That's good. Yes.
Have our guests arrived?
Yes. Everything's going according to plan.
Two are asleep and one's on the way. I used the preparation that you gave me.
That he gave you?
Yes, I knew it would work.
They should sleep long enough for us to get everything done.
Oh, you can count on that.
As a matter of fact, you can count on a lot more than that.
What do you mean?
Emily, your friends are going to sleep forever.
You told me those were sleeping pills. You said there'd be no more killing.
They had to be gotten rid of.
I don't want to do this!
Never mind, it's done.
Now listen to me, there's been a slight change in plans. I'm not coming up there. I want you to meet me at the castle. And then the helicopter will pick us all up from there.
Helicopter at the castle? Why?
Because I've just learned that Catlin Ewing has escaped and may know about the mountain house. He's probably on his way up there right now. Now you make sure that those three people are taken care of and then you get out of there fast.
Ross, wasn't it? He double-crossed you.
Must have been necessary.
Was it, Emily? Was any of the killing really necessary? I mean, what have the three of us got to do with babies?
Go to sleep. I have to go.
Sounds like I can expect to do a little more than sleep.
Just do it the easy way, please, Cass. Don't make me useless.
Emily, you can still help us.
No, I can't.
One could take us to the hospital, you could drop us off, and you could just leave. Your conscience would be clear then.
My conscience is clear. Everything I've done for the baby.
I know, the innocent babies, but we're innocent too.
Babies can't help themselves. I know. I know what it's like to grow up in a home with no love. That's why I have to help them.
Emily, you can carry on this mission someplace else, another country. I'll make a deal with you. If you help us out of here... She's got a gun! Hold on to her.
It's you.
Let me go!
Not on a bet, lady.
Anna, am I glad to see you?
What happened?
We've been drugged. She drugged us. It could kill us if I don't get us to a hospital soon.
What happened with Sally?
She's with Ross. He took her to some castle. I heard her say that they were going to wait for a helicopter there. You got to get there and stop them.
What about you?
I'll manage. The stuff hasn't taken full effect yet.
Okay. Where is this castle? I said, where is it?
I can't.
Emily, don't do this. Sally never hurt you.
It's near the airfield.
Which airfield?
The airfield, where we landed with the horses, right? I know where it is. You all right?
Yeah, I'll be fine. I'll take care of things here. You hurry up.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to tie you up. And then I'm going to take Kathleen and Cecile to the hospital.
They'll never make it.
the tower, sweet Miss Frame. You'll love it.
No, not going.
Alphonse and Victoria. Oh, hello. Just too bad. You just missed my wife. She left, oh, it must be an hour ago.
Really?
Yeah, I'll tell her you stopped by. So long.
No. That won't do, Mr. Wallingford.
Would you like to leave a message for her?
Well, as a matter of fact, that's exactly why we came by, to leave a message.
Okay, shoot. Let me have it. I'll write it down.
Only the message isn't for the lady. It's for Mr. Winthrop.
For Cass? Fine. I don't know when he'll get it, but I'm game to take it.
We were hoping that would be the case.
So what is it, the message for Cass?
Well, we're eager to tell you about it, but, you know, we prefer a place with a bit more privacy, so we can explain the message in detail.
Actually, Tony, I'm awfully busy right now. If you fellas could just come back a little bit late.
Now.
Well, Donna's never talked that way about Carl. At least not to me.
So you think Donna's quite put out with
him? I would say so, yes.
Well, it's no wonder the way Carl's been
Brian,
dragging his feet.
Brian,
offense.
I found out about Carl's father.
Oh? And?
It turns out that his father committed suicide. At least that's what Donna says.
Yeah, that's true, Sandy. That's one of the reasons I wanted to see you. I made some contacts abroad, as you asked me to, and that's all they were able to find.
Well, did they tell you any reasons?
No, none but the obvious. It seems the elderly Hutchins had some pretty bad business reversals about that time.
That's interesting. You know, Brian, I don't know why, but I'm starting to get a stronger and stronger sense that this whole thing with Mac is somehow tied into Carl's father.
But how?
Well, that's the question. And that's what I'm going to find out.
What?
It's important. Come on.
You have to go to sleep too late. Don't want
you. Kathleen, sit up. Can you hear me, Kathleen? Come on, wake up. We gotta go.
What?
Come on.
What happened?
We have to get out of here. We've been drugged on something. Now we gotta get out of here and go to the hospital. Come on.
Oh, who's sick?
Never mind that, Kathleen. Come on, help me.
I don't want to move, Kathleen.
Kathleen, wake up. You hear me? You have to.
Really?
No, because I said so. Now, come on, stand up. That's a girl.
Okay.
Good. No, come on, Kathleen. Stay up. Come on, shake your head around, Lou.
That hurts.
Good, that'll help. Now stay up on your own.
Yes.
Kathleen, I need your help. Come on.
No,
come on, help me out, will you?
Oh, please.
Come on.
Oh, Cass, I can't.
Okay, come on, Kathleen.
Go anywhere. I have to go to sleep now.
Come on, Kathleen, come on.
Don't you see it's no use? What did she say?
Kathleen, you stay awake. I'll be right back to help you, okay? Just stay awake. All right, Chris.
Drive.
I have to. Come on, help me. Help me walk. Come on.
up now. Stand up. Just a second. Come.
Well.
All right, hold on. Come there in the car. Where you go? Now sit.
No.
Sit.
Emily.
For the conclusion of Another World.
It was a pretty good show today, didn't you think?
Yeah, I think it was one of our better efforts.
That's not saying much lately.
Well, her mind has been elsewhere. I'm afraid it shows on the screen.
Well, I'm glad Mr. Hutchins' mind is elsewhere, too.
Yeah. Listen, I wonder where Wallingford is.
Well, he said he was going to stay and clean up, but didn't do too good a job, but... Well, what's this? Alphonse and Victoria?
Oh, listen, I hope I didn't hurt his feelings when I said that he should write his own book and not mine, you know.
Oh.
He's been a really good friend.
No, I don't think so. You did him a favor. You started him on a new career.
Yeah?
He might regret the competition later.
No, never. In fact, you know, if he's any good, I'm going to publish him. Oh, that's probably him.
I'll be right back.
Cecile, keep your eyes open. Can you keep your eyes open?
No.
Who's gonna... That's for luck. This is gonna be quite a ride. Okay, hold on. Stay away.
Buenos días.
Señor.
Mucho vino, ¿eh?
Hospital, doctor medico, el medico.
Muy borracho estás.
No, borracho, no. Sleeping pill. ¿Cómo se dice? Durmiendo.
Captain, where are you?
princess in the tower. Don't resist me, Sally. We'll be leaving soon.
Leaving for where?
Our trip. Just you and I together, princess.
To you by dark, sparkling Folgers crystals. Rich, delicious Folgers crystals in regular and decaffeinated. Join us.
This afternoon at 4, join Jennifer and Jonathan Hart for romance and adventure on Heart to Heart. Then at 5 o'clock, it's Trapper John.